Cloud computing loves almost all programming languages, whether they are compiled or scripted. It is part of what is so attractive for cloud engineers. This time we look at one of the most controversial when it comes to opinions about programming, PHP. We'll start by going back in time, way back to the early days of the public internet in 1994, where animated GIFs were still 3 years away and cat videos on YouTube more than a decade off existing. It is here that we find Danish-Canadian programmer Rasmus Lierdorf writing common gateway interface programs in C to power his personal homepage. Extending this work to run web forms and connect to databases, he coined the term Personal Homepage Forms Interpreter, PHPFI, or just PHP. And this is the part where I tell you that the first major implementations of the language were... However, let me quote the good man Lierdorf instead. "I don't know how to stop it. There was never any intent to write a programming language. I have absolutely no idea how to write a programming language." PHP was never conceived to be a language on its own. However, in the past 3 decades, it has come to power some of the largest websites such as Facebook, WordPress, Etsy, Wikipedia, and Flickr. PHP is optimized and tuned for web development, which is why cloud platforms love it. You can build secure, high-performing, and scalable web applications in PHP. To help you get started with your PHP application, there are many programming frameworks such as Laravel, Symfony, and CodeIgniter. These frameworks help with securing your application, reusing templates for common tasks and features, as well as enforce architecture patterns. All things that make you look good to the boss, I promise. It doesn't matter what kind of web project you are building, a website, a content management system, an online store, image processing, or data collection, PHP will excel at all of them. There are lots of integrated development environments or IDEs to help you develop amazing PHP applications too. The most popular are PHP Storm, Sublime Text, and Atom, but there are many others. PHP is a scripting language like JavaScript, Python, or Ruby. This means the PHP code runs on any server that has a PHP interpreter installed. While many languages have specific purposes they are designed for, PHP is known as general purpose. You can build almost any type of web application, it is quick to do so, and it runs everywhere. PHP comes with a vast number of frameworks, libraries, and pre-made code segments that you can use at your own leisure or peril. Remember at the top of the episode I said this is one of the most controversial programming languages? As easy as it is to get started with PHP and create your worldwide web domination, it is equally easy to make a real mess of it too. Statements and code segments that would throw warnings and errors in other languages can be valid in PHP and create results that no one expected. However, despite the controversy, that is also one of the strengths, as you can do very efficient and clever things with PHP, such as creating some of the best performing web applications on the internet. Also, all major cloud platforms support PHP as a primary language, and it is used in millions of cloud applications. Why should you learn PHP then? Well, first, it's a very mature and popular language. The 2021 Stack Overflow Developer Survey showed 22% of professional developers use PHP in their day job. PHP is free to use and open source, with most of the tools needed also free. PHP is platform independent, working on Unix, Linux, Windows, and Mac. You can use PHP for any modern web application, and it is fast, really fast. It is considered to be one of the fastest web languages around. I mean, why else would the social media behemoth Facebook, as well as our favorite open encyclopedia, Wikipedia, use PHP? Surely, that means it's good, right? Did you enjoy this video? Would you like to see more? Be sure to leave a like on the video and let us know in the comments what other cloud programming languages you would like us to cover. Except Jelly, CodeGolf is not for us.